Do you find it challenging to manage your experiments and results, especially as your work evolves over time? The Experiment Manager app in MATLAB helps you to create and manage experiments to fine-tune your systems. It allows you to run your MATLAB code with different parameter values and enables you to explore how your models and systems respond to these variations. In this video, we'll learn how you can use Experiment Manager to convert your MATLAB script into an experiment, run it for different scenarios, and analyze results. We have a MATLAB script here that consists of a system of non-linear differential equations that predicts the population of rabbits and foxes using the Lotka-Volterra predator-prey model. For such models, you want to see how different values of coefficients and initial conditions affect your model. Doing this manually and keeping track of all those results could be tedious, but Experiment Manager automates this process, allowing you to focus on investigating how changes in parameters impact your model. From the Apps gallery, under MATLAB, open Experiment Manager and create a new project. If you have Toolbox installed, you may see several pre-configured experiment examples. But for now, create a blank project and choose General Purpose. After specifying the name and location for the project, Experiment Manager opens a new experiment in the project. Provide a relevant description for the experiment. Then, add the names and the values of the parameters used in the experiment. Experiment Manager runs multiple trials of your experiment using a different combination of these parameters for each trial. In our case, it's the coefficients alpha and beta and the initial population of rabbits and foxes. The app has already set up a boilerplate experiment function for us. Edit this experiment function. Paste your MATLAB code here. And now to let Experiment Manager know which parameters to access from this code, replace the parameter variables with params.notation using the names for the parameters that you defined in the app. Also, rename the output arguments in the function based on your code, which in this case is the maximum and minimum populations of rabbits and foxes. Save the script and go back to the app. The experiment is all set up now. Set the mode to sequential and run the experiment. The experiment runs multiple times, with each trial using a different combination of parameter values. The result table displays experiment details, parameters, and corresponding output values. In the experiment details, you can track which trials are queued or completed and how much time they took for completion. Actions lets you control individual trials. You can cancel a trial to prevent it from running or delete it to exclude it from the results without needing to stop the entire experiment. While the experiment is running, the app generates custom visualizations based on the experiment function. In the Review Results section, select the desired plot and click on the corresponding trial for its visualization. You can switch between plots for trials by just clicking on another trial. These visualizations allow you to compare results and make quick observations. For example, from this plot, it seems like the fox population declines whenever the rabbit population is falling. The app also allows you to sort the results and apply filters. Point to the header of a column by which you want to sort, and from the drop-down, choose the sorting type. It seems like the parameter combination in this trial sees the maximum fox population. You can document such observations in the form of annotations. Click on Annotations and add annotations for this cell. To apply a filter on a parameter or on an output, go to the same drop-down, check the Show Filter box, and in the Filters panel, use the slider or type in the box, and the results table will be updated with the filter results. After you are done, you can export the results table to MATLAB workspace for further analysis. In some cases, you may want to modify parameters for the same MATLAB code and observe the system's response to these changes. Simply go back to the experiment definition, update the desired fields, and rerun the experiment. Now your experiment consists of a set of results for each run. Experiment Manager stores a copy of each experiment definition accessible through View Experiment Source. This allows you to access past experiment definitions and results and keep track of parameter combinations that generated those specific results. Experiment Manager keeps your experiments and results organized within projects. You can store multiple experiments in the same project and compare results across different runs. Now that you have learned how to use Experiment Manager, you can create, organize, and manage your experiments for journal purpose and advanced applications such as machine learning and deep learning. If you wish to learn more about the Experiment Manager app, visit the MATLAB documentation.